Hello, my dear students. In this video, I'm going to discuss an example of the password locker project. So probably you might be having the many accounts for which you might be using the different usernames and the passwords. And it is really a very bad habit to use the same password for the each account. So for that, the best way is to use the password manager on your system where you have only one master password to unlock the password manager, and then you can copy any account password to the clipboard and you can directly paste it to the website password field. So for doing that, we'll see what has been done here. So this is an example which shows or demonstrate the using of the password manager where you can manage the different accounts with the respective passwords and where you can fetch the password which can be directly pasted to the website wherever you require to open the account. So for doing that, here the design has been done using the command line argument. So as we go through this example, when we start execution and when we start the coding part, you'll get to know what is the command line argument. So for timing, you just understand that command line argument is a way of execution where you can pass the arguments while running the program itself. So instead of passing it into the code itself, so whenever you try to run it from outside the code, so you are going to pass the arguments through which you'll be able to execute the program. So here the same concept has been used. That means the account's password will be copied to the clipboard so that the user can paste it into the password field. So let's see how it has been done here in the code. So in this code, you can see here the very first line is the hash followed by the exclamatory mark, followed by the space and followed by the Python 3. So this is the mandatory line that has to be taken to the very first line into the code whenever you want to use the command line argument. So do remember that when you want to create the any command line program or whenever you want to run the any program through the command line arguments, so make sure that the first line of that program should be the hash followed by the exclamatory mark and followed by the space and followed by the version of the Python which you are using in your system. So in this we have the 3.7, so that's why the Python 3 has been taken here. So apart from that, you also require the two models for running this program, namely the sys model, the system model, which is termed as a SYS, and another one is the paperclip model, which is used to copy and paste the values from the keyboard and to the key system. So we have taken a dictionary known as a passwords through which we have created a small database consisting of the different accounts with the respective passwords here. So for example, the first element is email is the name of the account and value for this key is the password for that email, and similarly we have the one more account as a blog and corresponding value is the password for this blog, and luggage is another account for which this is a password here. So that means into this dictionary all the keys are the names of the accounts and their respective values are the passwords for that account. So you can see here we have the such a large password for which you need not have to remember this. So directly you will be able to copy this password by passing these account names as a command line argument. So to run this program, so whenever you say that any program in the Python, if you want to run them, you have to check out the how many arguments you are going to pass through the whenever you are running that program. So for this program, basically by mandatorily it is going to take the two arguments. So by default, the first argument always being the name of the program and the second argument being the name of the account, one among this to copy the corresponding password over there. So for that, here in the if statement we are checking whether there are the two arguments being passed while running this program or not. So in this case, you can see if length sys.argv. So do not get confused with this variable argv. So argv is an environment variable which will be created by default whenever you run the any program through the command line arguments. So all the variables is going to be identified with the respective index value like argv1, argv2 and argv3, depending upon the number of arguments that you want to pass to this respective program here. So in this program, we are checking for only the two arguments. The first argument being always the name of this program, the file name of this program, and the second argument being the one of the email or so one of the account name, that is one of the keys from this dictionary here. So if it is less than 2, it is going to exit, and simultaneously it is going to display one message known as the copy account password. So basically, if the arguments is less than 2, you will not be able to see the any output over there. So if the arguments is greater than 2, so the next thing is you have to get the argument that has been passed whenever you are running this program. So that is done with the argv of 1. As I told you, this is the environment variable which is by default created whenever you run the any program through the command line argument. So the first command line argument is the identified with the argv1, which is going to be fetched with the system module and will be stored in a variable known as a account. So for that, what you need to do, you need to check out whether the value passed by the user exists in this dictionary or not. That is, you need to check out whether the account name that has been passed by the user is present in this dictionary or not. So how it is done? Using the if statement here. So you can see here, we are checking here if account in passwords, that is, you are checking the keys here. So keys being the account names, and which is copied from the user, and the user that has passed, that is the user has passed. So if it is present, so next you are using the piperclip.copy. The piperclip module will copy the values from the dictionary and will be pasted you, which can be pasted into the website wherever you require. But right now we are not displaying the password on the screen. Instead, we are just copying it from the dictionary. So which value you want to copy, the value for that corresponding key, which if it is present in this dictionary. So we are copying it here with the respective value. You can see passwords being the name of a dictionary with account means the key value. For example, if we have passed it as an email, so it will act as a passwords of email. So passwords of email, in the sense, this password is going to be copied here. So the next, simultaneously, it is going to display password for email copied to the clipboard. It is not going to display that password. Instead, it will just copy. So if you wish, you can just paste it to the screen, or else you can paste it into the place wherever it is required. So if the argument that has been passed by the user is not present in that dictionary, in that case it is going to display as there is no account named with the value that has been passed over there. So this is the logic that has been used for this project here. So I'm not saying that it is exactly the application oriented project. It is just an idea demonstrated here. The same idea, you can use it with the proper interfaces or the proper GUI in your example over there. So to run this program, I must say that you need to remember that whenever you say that you are writing a program for which you want to run it through the command line, so for that you require the one more thing here. So you require a bat file to be created into the same folder where you have created this file here. So you can see this is a folder where I have written the pw file, the file which I have shown you just now. So in order to run that file through the command line, you have to require to write the bat file. So you can see here the Python script. The name of the bat file that I have created here is the Python script, which is created with a .bat extension. If you want, I'll show you here. So you can see a .bat extension here. So how to create a bat file is, open the notepad. So type this, the same information what I'm showing now here. You can see it is a notepad. So into this notepad, you have to type the same information what I'm sharing here. So you can see here, there is a file known as python.exe file. So this is the file which is located in the folder where you have installed the Python. So I'm not saying that you might be having the same path into your system, but wherever you have installed the Python, you go through that folders and you try opening all these respective folders. The name of these folders is going to remain same wherever you might have installed the Python. So in my system, I have installed it into the C folder. into the users folder Kanasu. At that folder, local programs Python 3732, and lastly this file exists over there. So try to search for this file python.exe into your system or into the folder where it has been installed, and whenever you find this file, so copy the respective path of the entire folder over there. That is, the absolute path of this file needs to be copied, and being a first party into this bat file, you just copy it into the double quotation. So followed by you leave a one space here, and in the next space into the one more double quotation, what you need to do is you need to copy the again absolute path of the Python file which you have created, the Python, the path of this file. So I have created this file into this folder here, the E drive followed by college classes pap ADP 5th sem class programs, and the name of the file is the it should be the pw.py. okay, so the name of the file is pw.py, and you just complete this double quotation here. So press the enter key, and to the next line you just include a @ symbol pause. So this is required to see the result. If you skip this part, probably just a blink of output will be shown to you, where you will not be able to actually see what is output you are getting for that particular program over there. So this this file needs to be created into the Notepad, but it has to be saved with the .bat extension. So that's the reason why it is showing the this symbol here, to make to show it as a bat file over here. So once and one more thing is, you need to remember that this bat file needs to be created into the same folder where you have created the Python file as well. So to run this, go to the command prompt. So go to the command prompt. Here what you are supposed to do is, first when you open the command prompt, it is going to take the admin's the drive over here, but you need to shift, or you need to shift to the path where actually you have saved the Python file over there. So for that you use the push d command. So just copy this path, so where you have created the file, and then copy that path as well. So you can see here the drive or the path has been changed to the folder where you have saved the Python file. So in this case, the next command that is required to run this program is py. So the name of the file, the name of the command to execute the Python file here is py, followed by the, so as I told you, if you want to run the any file to the command line arguments, by default the first argument is the name of the file. So here the first argument is pw.py, the name of the file, and I must say one, leave the space, one more value or the one more argument that you have to pass to this program is the name of the account, or else you can see the key, one of the key that you have created as an entry to the dictionary, so email. So once I press enter, so you can see here you got the result as a password for the email copied to the clipboard. Right, so this is the what is the output expected here. So let me compare these two things here. So you can see here as a output what I have done here. So whenever I'm running, so do remember to change the drive to the location where you have stored the Python file, and once you have changed the drive or the path, so you can, the command that is used or required to run the program is the py. So followed by, you can see here these two are the arguments that you are passing to say that you are running this program through the command line arguments, right? So these two are the arguments that you are passing, and hence you are checking here whether the arguments has been passed is at least more than two or not. If it is less than two, probably you are not going to get anything as a result. Instead you are just displaying a message as the copy account password, and where you are going to exit from the entire program itself, right? So for this reason you are checking whether the two arguments has been passed here or not. So you can see here one, first argument is pw.py, the name of the file, and the second argument is the key that you have, or else you can say the name of the account for which you want to check. So the next thing is, in this variable, account is equal to sys.argv of 1. So argv of 0 is the name of the file, and argv of 1 is the name of the first argument, or you can say the second argument, but with the index value 1 here. So this is going to be fetched. This argument is going to be fetched, and which will be stored into the variable account. Right. So once it has been stored into this variable, so the next thing is, you are checking whether this email is present in this dictionary or not. So it will search for this entry, this argument, whether it is present in this dictionary or not. So you can say it is present, and if it is present, it is going to copy the corresponding password here. So this is going to be copied through to the clipboard, and for which you are going to display the messages password for the email copied to the clipboard. So let me check what happens if I pass the argument which is not present for this thing. So simply I'll take some random value. So for which I want to check what the result it will show. You can see here, I have passed something which is not present in the dictionary here. So you can see AAA, for which it will check over here. So it is not present. So if it is not present, what it will show? There is no account named AAA. So you can see there is no account named AAA. So this is the simplest way to tell you that how you can effectively utilize the dictionary and effectively utilize the paperclip module to copy something and get pasted out to the clipboard here. I hope the example is clear to you, and even if you are not understood, then let me know. Thank you.